guys, Robbie here at the RV Corral. Today I'm showing you a beauty of a rig. I don't get to see these as often anymore, especially stuff in this good of shape, but this is a 2002 Country Coach Magna, which is their top dog when Country Coach was still in the game. This is a 40-foot rig with a tag axle. It's gonna be about the best driving rig you'll find going down the road. Country Coach was always known for their Dynamax chassis and a really smooth ride. It's powered by a C12 Caterpillar. That's 425 horsepower. And just a personal opinion, I've always preferred cats. It's what I have in my personal rig. Caterpillar is the way to go. They don't run them anymore because Caterpillar doesn't want to abide by emission laws. So this, the only way to get into a Caterpillar is to go back in age, and that's what this one has. It's paired with an Allison transmission. I apologize, it is a 6-speed, but it's either a 3000 or a 4000 series. I apologize, I don't know, but if it's important to you and you need to know, just reach out to me. But again, 40-foot tag axle. Another thing about tags that's important to note, obviously you're gonna get more stability going down the road, you have more rubber on the ground, but something a lot of people don't think about is having that tag axle actually brings your drive axle about 4 feet up, so you can corner a lot tighter because your wheelbase is shorter. Now you get a shorter wheelbase, but you end up gaining stability because you have a tag, so a win-win. 40-foot tag is going to be about the best setup you can have, and then on top of all that, it's a Dynamax chassis and a Country Coach. So anyway, after saying all that, let's do a quick walk around. Obviously she is a big beautiful blue. Paint is in near immaculate condition. You don't see any of the clouding or the gel coat failing on the top or in the rear. It's really one that hopefully it comes across in the camera, but something you gotta see in person to see how pretty it is. One of the first rigs to have side cameras on it, I believe in 2002, not a lot did, but you have a backup camera and side mounted camera. So when you flip your blinker on, you'll see down the rig, no blind spots. Generator is located right up front here. I believe it's an 8,000 watt Onan. My bay is locked there, so we're gonna go with 8,000 watt Onan. It is a diesel rig, or a diesel generator, runs off your diesel tank. Alcoa aluminum wheels here, 22.5-inch wheels and a tall tire. These are 315s, and I haven't checked the timestamp on them, but I have now. They are from the last week of 2023, so I would say mounted early this year in 2024 is safe to say. Two slide rig, so it leaves your patio space unobstructed by a slide and still gives you nice inside space. We'll see that when we get in there. But just beautiful paint. Country Coach is one of the few that did a hand-laid fiberglass. Regular construction of a motorhome, what they do is you have something like a Luon on the inside wall, and then they just glue and affix fiberglass to it. Not Country Coach, they hand laid their fiberglass, hence why you'll never see delamination on these things. It's straight as an arrow, and it will stay straight as an arrow. So again, 2002, and exterior is in better condition than you'll see in a lot of stuff that's 4 and 5 years old. So a testament to Country Coach and how good of a job they did. I'm gonna open this one bay. These two up here are pass-through. This is your wash bay, of course, nice and simple. You do have a black tank flush, black and gray tanks there. Pretty simple. You do have an outside shower. It doesn't need to be an overcomplicated system, so it's not. Dual wheels on your drive axle and a single rear wheel for your tag axle that does lift up for tighter maneuvering. You can do it auto, or you can do it so that it does it when you ask it to. I've always liked the way Country Coach didn't put bevels on their slides. It just made it look really clean. The way they do their seals, they don't need them. But a very nice system. It is HWH hydraulics on it, so it's very quiet going out. You'll see we have slide toppers on both of our slides, and something they don't do any longer, but they did in this era, was you can overextend these slide toppers, hook them to here, and actually double these as window awnings, so you can have your windows open on a, you know, a rainy day, keep fresh air coming in without water coming in. So a nice thing they did on the Country Coaches. We have a side mounted radiator, meaning our rear, the motor in the rear is exposed and easy to get to if you need to change a belt or just look at a beautiful Caterpillar motor. It's right there. These actually breathe and cool a little bit better too. They're getting a little bit cleaner air. The physics of it is you create a vacuum behind your rig, a slight vacuum behind your rig when you're going down the road at highway speeds. Here you do not have that vacuum. You're also not turning dirt as off or as quite as much as you do when you're in a tailwind. So cools a little bit better, but to me the big benefit is the fact that, bear with me, this is worth waiting for. You can get to your motor. So there's that beautiful yellow cat. Again, it's a C12, I think it's 11.9 liters, but 12 liter motor, inline six, makes great power. Again, rated at 4.25, but I've always felt like Caterpillars deliver more power than what is spec'd to. So especially from the get-go, from a starting line, this is the motor you want. It feels like it gets on it. You forget that you're 45,000 pounds or whatever this thing is. But anyway, again, I'm a little biased. Best motor in the game. We're not in the game any longer. Best motor they put in it. You do have the already set up for towing a vehicle with the rock guard on it. Again, like I already mentioned, it's a Dynamax chassis. And coming down the side, I didn't check this bay. Let's see what's in here. Nothing too exciting. These are chassis batteries, and I am not. I should know what that is, but I don't, so I'm not gonna say anything, but I do know what that is, and that is a very easy way to service your hydraulics, fuel water separator. Something they do a good job on these things is they make it easy if you wanna do your own service, to do your own service. So you have your fuel filter here, you have your oil filter here, you have a diagnostic right up there, you have the read for your air intake there for the air filter for when it gets full. So just really easy. If you want to do your own stuff, they make it as easy as they can for you to do your own work. All right, and down the passenger side, we do not have a slide, which to me is a huge benefit because when this awning comes out, you have unobstructed space. There's no slide to bunk your head on. There's nothing getting in your way. You just have a nice patio space to put out some lawn chairs and have outside food when you're ready to eat or just entertain. You also have slide toppers. Window awnings on all your windows on this side. And then of course that big awning covers these as well. So just double. This one, I think, what is here, propane? So just propane there, 20 gallon tank. Just looking at it, looks like a 20 gallon tank. And then these following ones are gonna be batteries. Some nice Lifeline AGMs. Those are not cheap batteries, but they have a lot of amp hours in them. And then these two are pass-through storage. I believe one has a Joey bed. They both have Joey beds. When I say Joey bed, I'm referring to these sliding floors here. This is a partial Joey bed, it looks like. Only goes about halfway, but comes out about 50% of its length. And same with this one here. But good pass-through storage for longer items. Okay, enough with the outside. Let's look at how they built this thing, because it's kind of, in a sense, it's a lost art how well they built these coaches in this era. I honestly don't know if they could do it anymore and keep it under $1 million with the quality of materials they use. So right at your main entry, you have a real tile floor. That was a big industry here in this area. These were built here in Coburg, just up the road. And it was a big industry builder for a lot of different companies, including tile manufacturers, because that was something they did a lot of. The carpet goes into your kind of living, entertaining area here, and then tile back into the bedroom through the kitchen. So nice setup there, but this is the kind of stuff you don't see anymore. There is not a piece of laminated wood in here. It is all solid, I believe cherry, looking at it. And just, I'll pull open a drawer and show you just there, the quality of construction, but even like a cathedral style glass there, here, and everything is a solid wood down to the pocket door and all your trim pieces. Right here across from your Euro bed, you have one of these nice fold away tables, and that's like a Corian type finish, so really nice heavy stuff. It's gonna last a long time. I'm jumping around, but look at the condition of these seats. I mean, this is normally where you see wear and tear on rigs, but even that driver's seat is near immaculate, which is just absolutely bonkers to me. I'm gonna sit down there and show you maybe a couple things that might matter to you. pretty simple display on your dash, on the cluster, everything you need. It's pretty easy to see, you know, PSI, temperature for transmission, for motor, fuel, all your normal stuff. You have your standalone monitor for your cameras, again, side cameras and backup camera. Head unit there has been updated. That's not a 2002. And then this is your computer diagnostic for the rig. So you can go through basically everything through the house and chassis through this piece here. 6-speed Allison. You do have a three-stage Jake brake, excuse me. Powered mirrors. What are we missing here? We'll leave it at that. There are some other stuff here, but I don't think it's worth noting. It's just kind of your standard things. All right. Living room, we have our couch opposing a Euro chair. We have the, like this, a two-person dinette with a couple of matching folding chairs, and then a leaf that will come onto this when you pull it out, but continue this table, make it a little bit bigger. It should come out to about there when you have the leaf in. Sorry, I'm a little bit of a dork about it, but even like your valances here, or I guess this is a valance, even like your, whatever you would call this piece, is all solid wood. This is something that really you only saw in the stuff that they built here in Oregon, but they were so proud of their work, they even put the drawer number, the employee number, and where it came from, because they were so proud of their stuff. If something broke, they wanted to be able to replace it. Not a lot of this stuff broke because they built it so darn well. Nice little chopping block that comes out. Again, good storage all through your kitchen for food. Porcelain sink, two burner stove, that's what I said. Microwave convection oven. A little bit of a dry bar here with more storage above it. We have a residential style fridge here, so a nice big fridge. Something you'd have in your house. And oh, that's locked. And the basement freezer, dual layer basement freezer, very, very nice. It's a solid update from the previous owners. And then my preferred style of bathroom, again, just because I like something doesn't mean you have to. Before I get to the bathroom, so I'm jumping around again. This pocket door, it's kind of one that you might not be able to appreciate until you see it in person, but even your pocket door, and in current day stuff, these are hollow, made of something just above cardboard, but this is all still solid cherry. You have a nice big mirror on the back here, but something you should check out when you come in, just kind of, it tells you how good of quality you're gonna see throughout this thing, when you can see even the pocket doors are made that well. But as I was saying, my preferred setup for a bathroom, you have this setup where you have a pocket door here and a pocket door here, so you can close off the bathroom entirely. So it's private to have the commode and the shower together. But if there's two of you and maybe one of you is in the commode, it won't stop the other one from showering. So to me, it's a win-win because you can use it either way when you have this split setup. So vanity here in the commode. Got this nice big shower. I'm gonna hop in there just for relative size. I'm about 6'1", a little bit more with my boots on, and I can literally put my hands straight up. That's gotta be close to 8 feet to the ceiling, and I can touch it, but just barely. Dual heads for the shower, and look how much room there is. I mean, there's even a seat, but definitely a nice big shower, bigger than some of us might have in our own homes. Heading into the bedroom, you have some storage here. Nice little pull-out drawers, makes it easy to load and unload and get all your stuff out, and nice and deep if you can see that. It goes probably almost 3 feet back or more, but nice big deep closets. Again, you have the second vanity here in your bedroom for getting ready, brushing teeth, anything like that if you don't want to do it in the commode. 7, 8 nice big built-in drawers here, a couple little bits of extra storage here. And then in our closet, you even have some built-in drawers. You have the top shelf and a nice rack for hanging things on. But a nice big closet if you're going to stay on the road for a while. You got a ton of storage in here. A queen-size bed that I believe has room for a queen-size bed. That is what that is, and that's what fits there. So queen-size bed is what that is. And then more storage above there at the head. So really, this is a rig that, you know, hopefully I think it comes across well in a video. It's something you got to see in person. So let's go back out here, see if I'm forgetting anything. and I'm sure I am. I'm not doing this thing justice with just how well built it is, how nice of a unit it is, and really how well kept it was. I mean, that's the real winner here, is the previous owners of this thing were proud of it, and you can tell it's immaculate on the inside and on the outside, especially for something of its age. And to get this kind of quality, the only way you can get this kind of quality without going to Marathon and spending $1 million is to get something a little bit older like this. So I think I'll leave it there, but thank you guys for checking out this video on this 2002 Country Coach Magna. I forgot to mention the only blue Magna of 2002, so it's one of one. But again, it's a 40-foot tag axle in just immaculate condition. So even if you're just interested, come on down, ask for me, and I'll show you everything I know about this thing, because I do know these old rigs very, very well. So appreciate you guys checking out the video, and I'll see you next time.